Andrew, thanks. In other news, violence in Venezuela continues as opposition groups protest the socialist government of President Nicolas Maduro. So far, 8 people have died and over 100 more have been injured in the streets of Venezuela as the political unrest and tension grows. Just yesterday, the Venezuelan government started shutting down citizens' access to media, which has prompted Venezuelans living in the U.S. to speak out. Today, Venezuelans living in the Permian Basin banded together to raise awareness of the conflict in their country. CBS 7's Macy Marigi was at today's demonstration. She joins us now live in the newsroom. Macy, what do these nationals hope to accomplish?
Well, Tatum, it's quite simple. They want people here in the United States to be aware of the political unrest in their country. Many of the people I spoke to today left Venezuela due to security issues, and many came to the U.S. to seek political asylum from what they describe as an oppressive government.
The political unrest in Venezuela can be felt as far as Midland, Texas. Dozens of Venezuelans sat in formations this afternoon, their mouths covered in tape.
We can't let ourselves, you know, tape our mouth. We have to speak out. You know, we have to be their voice.
Just yesterday, the self-proclaimed socialist government of President Nicolas Maduro stepped on the toes of national and international journalists.
Everyone has the same access to the media. So if we don't have the access to the media, how would we know what's going on? Can't talk about a democracy when the media is being shut down, when the internet is being shut down, when the cell phones are being shut down, you know, when there's no news. When you control every single thing, there's no democracy. That's a dictatorship.
Although Blanca Garrido has not been home to Venezuela in 7 years, she's no stranger to the atrocities that plague her homeland.
The police kidnapped my brother when he was there. So I don't have any intention of going back until I know things are better. You know, I don't want to put at risk on my daughter, you know, if things don't improve.
Blanca, like many others at today's demonstration, have moved to foreign lands to escape the danger.
When you tell a lie 1,000 times, people start to believe in that lie.
Now, Tatum, the group plans to continue to have more demonstrations as long as the conflict continues. Live in the newsroom, Macy Marigi, CBS 7 News.